Now from downtown Cleveland and Progressive Field, we've got baseball on the show. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Cleveland Guardians. First pitch coming your way next. Just about ready to go. And starting this one, Tristan McKenzie.
Well, just a three-pitch mix in his arsenal, which, you know, it's not a lot for a starter. So always very important for him to have a good feel and command all three. Sometimes you can make that three look like four if you add or subtract a little bit of velocity on one. But one thing about it, it can be easy to get too predictable out there on the mound. So hitters are aware of that. Mixing those three pitches in all counts is going to be a big key for him in this one.
A big swing and a miss.
Clearly, he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Righty to the plate. Glaber swings, drives one. Back there. And it's gone. The first batter of the game leaves the yard, and that gives them a lead. It's 1-0.
You can't ask for a better start than hitting a home run in your first at bat to give your team the lead. Well, you gotta love a game that brings some action from the jump. And at the plate, he was looking for a pitch to absolutely drive. And you know, leadoff hitters aren't up there anymore just working the count, trying to get on. They're looking to make some noise and do some damage.
And now it's Juan Soto. Hard ground ball, base knock.
Well, that was one of those high-percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. There was nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped, caught out in front, and didn't get under it like he would have liked, but definitely put a good swing on it.
Here comes Aaron Judge.
That's a ball.
The next offering misses. Two balls and a strike.
One strike.
Runner at first with no outs here. That one misses, and the count is 3-1. Right through there for a strike.
And boy, that was the pitch. 3-1. You want to be really aggressive on the fastball.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Here comes a pitch. Fights it off. You'll see another. Out to center. Freeman under it. And he makes the catch. And there's one down. And time now to check out the New York Yankees lineup. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
Well, we know guys are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with two strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a guy who's got decent pop.
Left-hand batter waits. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. And that's a foul ball. Here's a 1-2. And another ball. And a pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And he deals. That one ripped. That's a base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
That is good. The designated hitter, Giancarlo.
Giancarlo Stanton at the plate. Foul ball there. The pitch. Now this is in the air down the line, and no one can get to it. It's a foul ball. Two on, one out. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. And that just misses.
It's a good take.
Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, when you throw the same pitch back-to-back, that's how you want to do it. Set him up in the strike zone, then extend a little bit from there and see if you can get him to chase. Nicely done with the slider right there.
Here's Alex Verdugo. Two on, two outs.
Ball two.
This might be the most pressure you put on this guy today. You got one run in. You got to try to get another one or maybe two.
Here's a 2-1. And that one is in for a strike. First and second, two down. And we're just getting started here in the top of the first. And that one almost hit him. Two outs, and that is ball four, and the Yankees are in business. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Anthony Volpe. Just missed. And here it comes. And fouled off. And a 2-2. Out towards left center. And that's the third out. Looking back at the solo blast that led off the game, it's an early 1-0 lead. Back here in Cleveland, and pitching in this game, Luis Gil. What do we have on him?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
So in now for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan. The 1-1. That's the third. A sliding stop. The throw, and they get the out. Here's the Guardians lineup now. Already trailing by a run in this one. They'll be looking to get on the scoreboard early on as well.
Well, it's just the one run, so not too big a hill to climb. But, yeah, if they can answer back in this inning or at least in the next couple, that'll maybe settle everyone into this ball game, and that includes their own starter on the mound.
Here's Andrés Giménez. Up the middle, Torres. And two quick outs in the bottom of the first here tonight.
Batting third, the third baseman, Jose.
Now it's Jose Ramirez.
There's a strike.
Out there on the mound, he's setting the tone early with the fastball. 98 miles per hour up on the scoreboard.
Two outs, bases empty. And another ball. Gets a piece and stays alive. On the ground to the left, into the outfield, base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
Batting four.
Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
So two down. Here's Josh Naylor. That's down and in. And the right-hander deals. Fouls one off. 2-2. Left-hand hitter waits. And that's outside.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Ramirez off of first with two away. Swings and misses. And that ends the inning. One hit, one left. Second inning coming up from Progressive Field. Yankees 1 and the Guardians nothing. Second inning set to go. And here's the rookie catcher, Austin Wells.
Austin Wells.
Down the line, it's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
That was a thing of beauty. He may have been a little behind the pitch, but by getting that barrel into the hitting zone early on in his swing, he was able to meet it and still shoot a line drive down the line and left.
So up next, Oswaldo Cabrera. At the belt and fires. Breaking ball inside. Now 3-1. Right through there for a strike.
Count it 3-2.
Now. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Nobody out. Runner at first. Hit on the ground might be two. Rocchio to second on a nailer. They get two.
Nice soft hands on the backhand right there in the sixth hole. Starts the double play. That's not an easy throw, but he puts it on the money. Really good job to get that double play started.
Back to the top of the Yankee order. Gleyber Torres digs in now. The 2-2. Swing and a ball hammered left field. And that one is off the wall. The throw into second. And he'll make it to second base with two gone.
That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
And in scoring position with two away. And up next for New York, Juan Soto. The pitch. And they're at the knees. And it's one and two. In the air, right center. This is mashed way back and gone. A massive home run. And they add a pair. It's 3-0.
You almost feel bad for the baseball when Juan Soto hits it. His swing is so powerful.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Base is empty with two away. Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. And another ball. Two down, nobody on. Hard on the ground to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Two-run blast for the Yankees this inning. It's now 3-0. Major League Baseball is on the show. Back now at Progressive Field. Leading off, Ramon Laureano.
The right fielder, Ramon Laureano.
The wind of the pitch. And there's the strike.
A 3-0 lead is great, but you can't get too comfortable. Got to stay aggressive, keep attacking hitters, try to cruise through this ballgame.
Out towards right center field. Puts it away for the out.
Batting six. The catcher.
Bo Naylor at the plate now.
Naylor.
Into left center for a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one out single.
That was maybe even a little off the plate, but no problem getting the barrel to it. Man, he does such a nice job, and that's what you're supposed to do with the pitch in that location.
Will Brennan digs in for the Guardians. Yankees up by three. Bottom half of inning number two. And it's even up.
Cold night tonight, Boog, and that's a pretty firm fastball right there. I tell you what, memories of getting jammed, they are creeping into my mind right now.
Next one misses, 3-2 down.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Strike three, got him looking on the changeup.
This guy will throw any pitch in any count, 3-2. He goes off speed, gets the out.
And at first, here's Tyler Freeman to hit.
Freeman.
Two outs. That one drilled left field. Verdugo makes the catch, and that'll do it. One left for the Guardians. They trail in this one 3-0. Here in Cleveland, Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate.
Anthony.
You know, Boog, from time to time, players mix up their routine if things aren't going their way, and Rizzo is no exception. When he was in a slump in 2023, he changed his walk-up music to Taylor Swift. No bad blood there because it worked. He went 4-for-4 and hit his first home run in over a month. He even gave credit to Swift after the game.
Next pitch is outside.
Garley's back out here for the third, and after the first couple of innings, pretty rough. I think the skipper's looking for him to give him a little bit of length, see if he can save the bullpen some.
Sneaks through, base hit, and the leadoff man aboard.
That's back-to-back singles for him. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock, and you'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole.
And now it's Giancarlo Stanton, the pitch. And there's a foul ball. One and two here, and another ball. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Rizzo around second. And now runners at the corners, nobody out.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Now the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. The pitch. And downstairs.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Runners at the corners. Nobody out. We're here in the top half of inning number three. And that is in for a strike. It's 2-2.
Great spot to be in right here for the pitcher. You can either strike this guy out or get a ground ball double play.
And the pitch. Left field. Kwan makes a nice grab at a full sprint.
Now batting the shortstop, Anthony Volpe.
Anthony Volpe stepping in now for the Yankees. Ground ball could be two. Flips it for one.
Out.
And they bounce into two already. This one ends the third. So no runs, two hits, no errors, and one left on. We head down to the home half of inning number three. Yankees 3 and the Guardians nothing. And we're back. Bottom of the inning. Here's Brian Rocchio.
Not shortstop. Brian Rocchio.
Broken bat, and it's popped up. Cabrera right there to make the grab. And there's one away.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Stephen Kwan getting ready to hit. One out, base is empty. And another ball. That one fouled off, 2-2. One down, base is empty. That one just misses. In the air to left center. Verdugo running hard. Tracks it down for the out. And there are two outs.
Now batting. The second baseman.
Now it's the second baseman, Andrés Giménez. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. just really impressive because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit.
Rolls across the diamond. What a play. Inning over. No runs, no hits, no errors. Three innings complete. Yankees 3 and the Guardians nothing. And welcome back to the ballpark as we go to the top of the fourth. Leading and here's the catcher, Austin Wells. Catcher,
number 28, Austin Wells.
Up and in, now 2-2. Cleveland has some action going in their pen. Hunter Gaddis up and throwing. Beatty also throwing. And a swing and a miss. And now one away.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Cabrera.
Base is empty, one away. Top half of inning number 4. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. One down, base is empty.
We got a full count.
Line drive, base hit. So that will bring up the top of the order with one away.
Now batter.
Second back base. To the top of the lineup. Gleyber Torres up to hit. That one hit to right. Laureano makes the catch.
Now batter. The right fielder. Juan Soto.
Man at first. Juan Soto stepping in now for the Yankees. Cabrera, the runner at first with two gone. And a foul ball. Kicks and deals. Got him. And that'll do it. The Yanks lead one. But they lead it 3-0. Back here in Cleveland, John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Jose Ramirez.
Ramirez.
And the righty deals. Up and in. Now two balls and a strike. You and I got a chance to broadcast the 2019 All-Star Game, and the city of Cleveland did such a great job. I felt like wherever you turned, there was some type of ad for the All-Star Game, a face of one of the players playing in the game. I thought the city overall supported the event really well. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Three, two now. That's a base hit. So he battled through a long at bat and earned himself a hit.
Yeah, and I think the players backed it up from the home run derby and the show that was put on between both Vladimir Guerrero Jr., Pete Alonso, and others. It was off the charts. And then the game is always special When you see the best in baseball, you remember how special this game is. And to be here at this ballpark, I think just was the icing on the cake.
And another ball. And a pitch. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The pitch. Down the line. And that will drop foul. The Yanks leading by 3. We're here at the bottom of the 4th. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. That's to 3rd. Finds its way through. Base hit. Throw back in quickly. 1st and 2nd now with nobody out.
Not much to do then. The right fielder.
Laureano comes up to hit. Next offering upstairs. And that one fouled off. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Verdugo gets under it. And there's one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Stepping up for the Guardians, Bone Naylor. Next pitch, not close, up high. Two on, one out. Good job to fight that one off. Laboring here, about to throw his 30th pitch of the inning. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Fouls it back with 2 strikes. Left-hand batter waits. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a 2-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs.
And a swing and a miss. That's the 3rd out.
Couple of strikeouts with runners on. Sometimes you got to really bear down, and he did just that. Nice job of getting out of the jam and out of the inning.
We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the 5th. Hunter Gaddis.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
It's Aaron Judge now. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base and slugging too.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable, and because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
That one misses, and the count is 2-2. And there's a hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. Righty to the plate. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Judge gets his lead at first, nobody out. Hits and misses, it's a strikeout.
Well, that was a tough slider right there. He couldn't get a piece of it just to try to keep the at-bat alive. And hitters will tell you, that slider, when a guy's able to really tunnel the pitch where it looks like a fastball and then late, has really good bite, so tough to lay off of because you've made the decision you don't want to get beat by a fastball, and then you swing and you miss, and you go back to the dugout shaking your head.
Now here's Giancarlo Stanton.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Two gone.
Oh, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts. So they haven't been able to move that runner out, get him in the scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
So two down now, and here is Alex Verdugo. And a pitch. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And that is that. One left for the Yankees, but they lead it 3-0. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth, and taking over on the mound, Tanner Tully.
Well, I got to think he probably has a little extra in the tank facing his former team, and there's not a player in the league that doesn't get a little extra motivation when he plays against his old squad.
So in now for Cleveland, Tyler Freeman.
The center fielder, Tyler Freeman.
A wind in the pitch. Fouls one off, 2-2. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. And it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. Safe at second with a leadoff double.
Showed some really nice patience in that at-bat. Worked himself into a good count. Absolutely blasted that one into the gap, but just didn't have quite enough to clear the wall out there. Maybe a little more elevation under it, and it carries over, but that's a swing you'll be happy with every time.
Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Ryan Rocchio. Breaking ball, and that got him.
You know, Boone, there always seems to be that no moment for the pitcher when he's lost control of his pitch, and most of the time, it's right when he lets it go. He knows that it's not headed where he intended it to go.
And he deals. And a foul ball. And that's in the dirt. And the count's even at two.
Well, he might have to look for a different put-away pitch right here at 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at-bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
And now the lefty. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's the 2-2. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
And stepping in is the speedy Andrés Giménez. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Drops into the glove.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Here's Jose Ramirez.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against it.
On the ground to third, Cabrera. Slings to first, and Ramirez is set down. And that will end the inning. Guardians strand a couple, still down 3-0. Back now at Progressive Field. Now it's going to be Anthony Volpe. The wind of the pitch. Swings through that one out in front that time.
One ball. No fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move to the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just kind of have to tip your cap on that pitch.
The shortstop takes the ball. There's a swing and a drive. Freeman ranging back. And he brings it in on the warning track. Here's the catcher, Austin Wells. Base is empty, one away, and we're the top half of the sixth. That one fouled off. Two on the way. And he chases that one. Now two away.
Oh, really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike pitch right there. At worst-case scenario, it's weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
And now it's switch-hitting third baseman Oswaldo Cabrera. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Two down, nobody on. Popped in the air, left field. And that is that. Nothing across here this half. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. Yankees 3 and the Guardians nothing. Bottom of the six. And here's the first baseman, Josh Naylor.
The first baseman.
Fouled off. He was late. Swing and a pop-up. One away.
The right fielder, number 10. Ramon Laureano.
Here's Ramon Laureano. The Yankees leading by 3 here in the bottom of the sixth. called strike right there.
Well, in this one, the offense has sputtered. Somebody's got to find a way to get on, keep the line moving, and manufacture at least one run. Then maybe you get two or three.
This one in the air. Settles under it. Hauls it in for the out. Two down.
Well, that's what he's looking for with the fastball above the zone. A swing and miss or weak contact.
Whoa.
And next is the Guardians catcher, Bo Naylor. And a 2-1 on the way. And that one fouled off. And miss, struck him out. Guardians go down in order. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. They trail it here 3-0. So the batting order turns over. Here's the Yankees leadoff hitter, Gleyber Torres. Righty delivers. And another ball.
You know, these Yankees really impressing me with the quality of their bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. They keep finding themselves behind in the count, but it really hasn't mattered in this one. Seven of their hits have come in disadvantaged counts, and I think that helps create a mental advantage for this team.
In there at the knees, and that is strike two.
I say that about the mental edge because on the mound, it's extremely frustrating to not be able to put hitters away, and that's exactly what we've seen here.
That's a good at-bat right there. He was down early in that plate appearance. Works the walk. The 3-1. Ground ball to the right side. And it finds its way through for a hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
The center fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
Aaron Judge at the plate. And another ball. Kicks and fires. Just missed. Smash to center, way back, and you can forget it. Home run. That was blasted to the moon, and they tack on three. It's 6-0.
The sun rises, and Aaron Judge hits a home run. That's a pretty normal day in the world of baseball. Pitcher tried to intimidate with that fastball up and in, but he was ready for it. Pulled the trigger, and man, explosive through the zone right there.
A new pitcher in the game, Tyler Beede.
I think it's got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. Just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way because these batters count the same for his stats, obviously, regardless of the score.
And next for New York, Anthony Rizzo. Nobody on, nobody out. Here at the top half of inning number 7. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And here comes. Pitch misses. And now it's 3-2. at the belt and fires. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Ramirez drifts towards it, hauls it in, and there's one away.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Giancarlo.
And here is Giancarlo Stanton. Chopper right side. Toss to Naylor, and they take care of Stanton for the out.
The batter, the left fielder, Alex.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. The pitch. Lined into right. Laureano pulls it down, and that is that. Yankees with a three-run shot. It's now a 6-0 ball game. Will Brennan now at the plate. Next offering is in for a strike. Activity in the bullpen for the Yankees. Victor Gonzalez, the lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. Hamilton, the right-hander, also getting loose. Inside, just missed. Foul tip into the mitt, struck him out.
Well, they've had a great plan of attack for him tonight. I mean, finding all the holes in his swing and his approach, just frustrating for him up there. You strike out a guy three times in a game, I think that guy's got to go back and really study some video with his hitting coach, figure out how they're beating him, make this adjustment really quick, because word will get around the league in a hurry.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play. The 2-2. And they'll do it again. Ripped on the ground a second. Two up, two down.
The batter number 4. Shortstop, Ryan.
And up next for Cleveland, Brian Rocchio. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. Two outs. And that skips in the dirt.
Two balls, two strikes.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Judge makes the catch. That is the inning. And the batter will be the shortstop, Anthony Volpe.
The shortstop, Anthony Volpe.
The shortstop takes the ball. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
And stepping in for the Yankees, Austin Wells. That one at the knees for a strike. The Yanks up big in this one, and we're at the top of the eighth. Next pitch is downstairs. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Lifted in the air down the left side. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away.
Third baseman, Oswaldo
Cabrera. Oswaldo Cabrera stepping in now for the Yankees. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Well, two outs and a chance to put up a zero on the scoreboard here, and that's not something that's come easy for this staff in this one.
Next offering upstairs. Chases the changeup in the dirt. Naylor collects, fires to first. That completes the strikeout, inning over. So digging in, Stephen Kwan. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Not even close there. Two balls, two strikes. When you look at the elite teams in the game right now, there is going to be the slug, no question about it. But the really good offensive teams combine slug with more contact, with less swing and miss. Makes the catch, and there's one gone.
Now back, second baseman,
Andrés Giménez will hit next. One down, base is empty. Just off the inside edge.
I can't play around with him here. It's a six-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters, even if you give up a solo shot.
The 2-1. Just missed. Base is empty, one away. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Puts it in the air out towards left center. He makes the grab, and there's two away.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Jose Ramirez digs in for the Guardians. Two down. Popped up. Gets under it. Makes the catch, inning over. The Guardians go down in order. They still find themselves down 6-0. Here comes Gleyber Torres.
The second baseman, Gleyber Torres.
Splits the plate, 1-2. And the pitch comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. Naylor down to first. Got him. One away on the strikeout.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Juan Soto.
Juan Soto now. That one well upstairs. 2-1. One down, base is empty. There's a swing and a miss.
Two balls, two strikes.
Crushed to right. This one's got a chance. Out of here. Home run. Another homer. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. It's 7-0. That's their fourth home run of the game.
They can't stop, and they won't stop hitting home runs in this one, Boog. They're clearly feeding off of each other at the dish. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Base is empty, one away. And now big number 99, Aaron Judge. That one way outside, and it's 2-1. Judge rips that one, and that is a foul ball. One out, base is empty, and a run in here at the top of the ninth. And another ball. Pulls the string with the changeup, struck him out. Two outs, base is empty. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Anthony Rizzo. Here comes a pitch. Now he breaks his bat. Beatty makes the grab, and that'll do it. The Yanks do get one on the solo homer. It's now 7-0. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. And now it's Josh Naylor.
For the Guardians, the first baseman.
The lefty fires.
Naylor.
Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did. Ripped to short. Volpe throws to first in time. And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
The right fielder, number 10, Bravo, Laureano.
He's two outs away. Stepping in, Ramon Laureano. The pitch. The Guardians with a lot of ground to make up here in the last half of inning number 9. This to third, and it's off the bag. Oh, and it hits the base. He's in there.
Not every base hit is a liner into the gap, just like not every strikeout's a perfect slider down and away. I mean, right there, he just put the ball in play on the ground and gave it his all to get down to first for the knock.
Man at first with one gone, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Bo Naylor. Left-hand hitter waits.
Ball.
I mean, his pitch efficiency, ability to get ahead in the count, at times pitch to contact, let the defense work behind him. That's why he's still in the game here in the ninth inning.
And he deals. Swing and a ball popped up. Volpe makes the catch, and there's two down.
That was a good, hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop-up and an easy out for the defense.
Ball to strike. Lifted to left, and that should do it. He's got it. Ball game. The Yankees used two pitchers to combine for the shutout.
We saw complete domination in this one. The offense exploded for a blowout, and then the pitching staff nails, locked down the opponent. This team did everything right today.
This one ends 7-0. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, 7 runs on 13 hits, no errors, they left 7.